Hola, mi gente. It's me, Manny Perez, with the film La Soga, Boston Latino, in the house, people.
We are here with Manny Perez, famous Latino actor and star of La Soga, who is currently here in Boston to promote the new film. Hi Manny, how are you?
I'm good, how are you? Thank you for having me.
Being a famous Latino actor, you must have a lot of stories. What has been your most memorable story?
I was up for my first TV series was this TV series called 100 Centristry. So it was with Sidney Lumet, who's a big time director and well established. So I go in and I audition for this man, and you know, and I thought I didn't get it, because I flopped it. It was a horrible audition. I'm like, I'm not gonna get this. So I take the subway home, because I was like down and out. Took the subway home, and by the time I got up to my subway stop in Washington Heights, where I live, I got a phone call from him directly saying, "Hey, I loved your work. This is, you know, this is your part. It's great, great, great." Man, I started crying like a little baby. So that was one of my one of those moments that sort of inspired me to continue going where I'm going with this film, with my career.
So Manny, give us an idea of what La Soga, your new movie, is about.
Well, La Soga, you know, it's a very personal story. It's a story that was happening in La Soga, is happening in every third world country, from Mexico to Dominican Republic, where we shot it, to Colombia, to Guatemala, to China, to Africa, and it's about corruption and how corruption is destroying the poor. What's special about La Soga is that it's based on true events. Something that happened in front of me when I went on vacation to my hometown in Santiago, in Dominican Republic. In my story, you see a monster, La Soga, at the beginning. You hate him at the beginning. At the end, you fall in love with him for what he does. And that's the story about La Soga. And it's really a beautiful story. That's why the film got into Toronto Film Festival, one of the biggest film festivals in the world. And it's conquering hearts across the world, because it's such a beautiful story. Well told, and again, it has a heart to it. It's not just about action and adventure. It's like more of a redemption story.
Manny, why should we support this Latino film?
Well, I have an issue with Latinos. I'm a Latino, and I'm a proud Latino. And I've worked in every Latino film you can think of, from Bella to El Cantante to Illegal Tender to Pride and Glory, to every Latino films, I'm the guy they see. And I feel like the reason why Latino films, they're not making more about Latino stories, because we as Latino are not united to go support the film. For example, when an African-American film comes out, all the African-Americans come out and support. We as Latino, we're so... Well, that's not my story. That's a Mexican story. That's not my story. That's a Puerto Rican story. That's not my story. It's a Dominican story. At the end of the day, we're all Latinos. There's a white man sitting in Texas saying, that's a Mexican, even though we're not Mexican, but to him, we're all as one group. So I feel like as one group, we got to support our stories. In this case, there's a Latino story. So we should definitely go out and support, so they can make more stories about us. If we don't support, they're not going to make.
Some deported drug dealer killed his father a while back.
No!
Now he works for me.
Soy Jenny. ¿Te acuerdas de mí?
¿Y cuánta gente nos ha matado tú por lo de tu papá? ¿Y tú piensas que él diría de ti?